The university sector is slowly recovering from a dearth of international students and their fees caused by the COVID border lockdowns. But our universities have also had to adapt in other ways, as the skills shortage in Australia puts pressure on workplaces and also those who train future workers. Linda Brown is President and Chief Executive of Torrens University, which has 14 campuses in Australia and around the world, and recently was announced as a candidate for the EY Entrepreneur of the Year Awards. Linda, thank you for your time today. I just want to point out to people that your university is different to those that most people know.
Yeah.
And it's different because it's privately owned, isn't it?
It's privately owned. We've got technically three privately owned in Australia, but they're really foundations, not for profits. We're NASDAQ listed. We've got an American board. We've got an Australian board here. So really, we're a business. We're in the business of education.
OK, so let's go to that whole issue about skills readiness, because that's partly what the budget was about. Because we know there's a shortage of workers. Unemployment rates are at all-time lows in Australia, or they're going there. And so that means there is pressure on institutions such as yours to put out job-ready workers or to retrain people.
Yeah, both, I think. I mean, this is a brand new university. It was built from nothing, from a green field, and opened its doors 8 years ago with 149 students. We've now got over 20,000 students. And we really, when it wasn't sexy, we really were shouting employability, employability, employability. That was the space that we found in the
Australian
market.
OK, so give me an example of that.
So let me give you an example. I'm in Sydney with you today. Thank you very, very much. And I've been staying at Overlo Hotel. So walk into Overlo, the girl behind the reception desk introduces herself. She's a Blue Mountains graduate, probably paid 100 grand for her degree, and is working at Overlo. They've also, we don't develop any curriculum, any teaching or learning materials without having an industry partner and 12 people around the table who are prepared to put their brand on it. So our customer experience hospitality short courses are all sponsored by Overlo. So our students not only get a qualification, they also get accreditation from the industry. And that's critical for us. We'll use them for our leadership series. We'll do partnerships and research. So we are industry's university. We created this university in partnership with industry.
OK, so is it industry that leads where your courses go? Is it industry that leads you to try and, you know, shall I say, hone your university students in certain ways?
100%. So if you think, we do business cases. You know, we have a whole centralised futures production unit, if you like, that creates the best curriculum in partnership with academics and industry. 70% of the people who teach for me, 2,000 staff, didn't pay one of them off during COVID, really proud of that, are pracademics. They work as well as teach. So everything that we do is built around that industry relationship. You won't hear me chatting at a university conference. I work with ACCI, I work with AmCham, I work with industry boards, and listen.
OK, so just explain to me how the lack of students coming in during the COVID lockdowns has had an impact on your university, because you've continued to grow during this period of time.
Yeah, it's been crazy. We've grown 28%, Ross. And we were already a hybrid university. We believe in choice. We believe that at every subject level you should be able to change, to choose, to do it digitally, face-to-face or online, because we really believe in mass personalisation and us serving you as an individual, not serving what the university wants to do. So we were able to pivot really, really quickly when COVID happened. And within 2 weeks, we had 50% of our curriculum that wasn't online. We put it online. And what we did with our international students, we had 11,000 and kept growing, 28% during COVID, was we suddenly had 4,500 students offshore who couldn't come back to country, but who wanted to continue studying. So we pivoted and put in 24/7 centres in Colombia and Sri Lanka and all over the world to support them. And we made sure that they could continue learning and my staff could continue working.
OK, coming back to Australia, Josh Frydenberg famously a few weeks ago said, look, if you want a pay rise, get a new job. And a lot of what was in the budget was about basically retraining and reskilling people to adapt. Now, this again comes back to exactly what you're doing, to allow a person to get on in life and maybe to not be irrelevant as their industry disappears. They've got to retrain. And that's one of the keys in the choice of courses that you offer.
And even more so than that, we made we're a B Corp, which means that we're a registered public benefit corporation. So even though we're private, we believe in the beautiful business and we're on the NASDAQ, so we are very business minded. But it means that we also look at using private money for public good. We put out free short courses during COVID because we knew that everybody was struggling with their mental health. We did a free course with Beyond Blue in partnership that went to 16,000 people on mental health, and 120,000 people in Australia engaged with our short courses for free and did that during COVID.
Great to chat to you on the program today. Many thanks for your time.
Appreciate your time. Thank you.